removal of the Hammel Woods Dam sure did generate a lot of interest from the public. And we are happy to say that this project was executed swiftly and safely with a positive impact on the DuPage River for years to come, not only here in Hammel Woods, but throughout Will County. While removal happened in just a matter of weeks, planning for this project took years and coordination with other organizations, such as the Lower DuPage River Watershed Coalition and the Conservation Foundation. Funding was made possible with a grant from the Lower DuPage River Watershed Coalition. The coalition is made up of municipalities and park districts along the DuPage River in Will County.
So I work for the Conservation Foundation and I provide staffing to the Lower DuPage River Watershed Coalition. As a partnership that we have between our two organizations because we can do more together than we can do individually. This project has been really a keystone project for the coalition to remove this dam and increase access and movement of fish up into the upper parts of the watershed, helping to improve our water quality and health of our aquatic ecosystems.
The dam was constructed in the 1930s by the Civilian Conservation Corps, which was a work program funded by the federal government. They constructed the dam originally to create a pool of water for recreational uses, and those would have included both fishing as well as swimming and other activities that were in the water.
Back in the early 2000s, the Conservation Foundation had received grant funding through the Illinois Department of Natural Resources Conservation 2000 program to really look at what the impacts of dams were in the DuPage River system. So we looked at dams along the main stem of the DuPage and up into the east and west branches of the DuPage River and identified a number of dams that really served no purpose any longer. And so through that study, we identified a number of dams, including this one here, that really, like I said, pose no additional benefit as far as flood control or stormwater management or anything like that, and really could be slated for removal to improve the health of our streams.
Based on the studies that they had done, we're able to show that the ecology of the river was different downstream than it was upstream of the dam. That was confirmation for what a lot of people suspected, and that was that the dam created an impediment to the free flow of fish and other species in the river. So it's not often that we get to do restoration in a stream or in a river. We do that, of course, at times. So most of our restoration work is terrestrial or land-based. It's a little bit different, quite a bit different, than some of our other what I would say run-of-the-mill or standard projects that we do that sometimes require only one or maybe two permits, and they're local permits rather than federal and state permits.
While some people objected to the removal of the dam because they had personal connections to it, now there are different opportunities for visitors to create new memories in the spot.
Part of our human nature is to be a little resistant to change, but this change reflects what we've learned about the river, and that these types of structures are really bad for the health of the river. It creates this wall. And so, although this is something different, it is something new to embrace, because we are going to continue to see really great things from this project.
So with this project, unlike a lot of other ones, is that the contractor is basically under the gun as soon as they get in river. Right? So as soon as we got mobilized and the cofferdam systems were put in place, the contractor needs to go as fast as they physically can and still do a quality job while they're doing it, so that they can get out of the river before potential heavy rains happen and either take existing equipment with it or just mess up the whole entire program and set you back weeks, if not months, in the process. As soon as material and everything gets out on site, tree clearing happens, and then the next thing that happened with the project was the cofferdam system, which was established by a company called Fortidam that's out of the Northeast. They're a subcontractor in the project. They got in river, and they would set up their structure, if you will. It was a steel frame, and bolt that into the bedrock. And as soon as everything was secure, we did it on a half river system, right? So we isolated half of the river during phase one, and phase two is the second half. but as soon as the structure was up, they would peel over a vinyl tarp and put down sandbags to seal the, the river's edge portion of that. Pump the water out. As soon as the water is to a level that we can get equipment in there, that's when the heavy equipment would come in and either, jackhammer out or excavate out the existing material in the dam.
The removal of this dam along the DuPage River is really important because it's going to allow fish passage all the way up into the upper reaches of the east and west branch of the DuPage River, especially as the watershed groups up there have actually, already removed dams. And so this will be really a way to get that extension all the way up into the DuPage County portions of this watershed. So in addition to just the dam removal itself, you'll notice that there are a number of large boulders and stones put in place in the river. That's to help create better habitat for fish and macroinvertebrates in the stream. Most dams were built on spots of the river that already had a riffle, so likely there was a riffle in this spot, and that just adds to the diversity of habitat in the stream, allowing for more places for fish and macroinvertebrates, the bugs in the stream, to find habitat and expand their populations. So that riffle is an important component of the restoration part of this project.
While the removal of the dam and the attached overlook are the changes you'll immediately see while visiting, the shoreline will evolve over time.
So when people come back in the spring, everything's going to be a little bit taller, but with everything that was seeded, it's a woodland seeding mix, so it's going to be taller grasses. And this is actually part of our viewshed management program as well. So the idea with this is to be able to see the river from the parking lot, have a direct connection when you come here. So there'll just be some tall grasslands that get in there. It'll take a couple years to establish the trees that have a canopy over the top of them. And you'll be able to sit on the river's edge, throw your kayak in the water, and paddle around.
In the long term, we'll start seeing more animal diversity and overall improved river ecosystems. These partner organizations have already seen results based on previous dam removals up north.
We pretty much started to see immediate increases in fish as they moved up well beyond even what we expected. Fish moving up into species of fish that were only found kind of between this dam and the dam up in the Warrenville area. There are a few dams up there. They're really only seeing those fish here in between those dams. Once they removed those dams upstream, they started immediately seeing fish moving upstream on the east branch at Churchill Woods, fish movement within that same season and then into the years after it. So we really do expect to see movement of fish really rather quickly.
Even though, there's a lot of initiatives and a lot of studies to get something like this done, you have to have the will to do it and the longevity to permit it as well as to pay for it.